day. My name's William from Penn Electric Racing. We're a group of about 40 students that builds electric vehicles. This is our first battery electric car. It's an electric drag racer. It was started in 2006 and we'll be finishing it up this year. When the signal comes through from the accelerator, it goes into our motor controller, which is this green box here. Now, if you hooked up the batteries, which are in the back, directly to the motors, you'd get your max voltage and you'd be running at your highest speed all the time. So we need the motor controller to control the speed of the vehicle. The way it does that is it basically turns the batteries on and then turns them off very quickly, and it does this thousands of times in a second. And this allows the motors to feel like they have a lower voltage and to travel at a lower speed. In the back, we've got 23 deep cycle lead acid batteries that were donated to us by Exide. This gives us our total voltage of 276 volts. Although these were kind of what was available in 2006 when the project started, they're a little bit outdated now in terms of the technology. So on our next vehicle, we're going to be using lithium ion cells, and we've already secured a donation from Tesla Motors. At Penn Electric Racing, we're passionate about clean technology, and this includes a clean vehicle backed up by a clean power generation system. Now, one of the things that you need to remember about electric vehicles today is that even though if you're charging it now, you'd probably get half of that energy from a coal-fired power station, we still need to get these vehicles out there so that in the future they will allow us to go towards a completely clean system.
We hope that by working on this, we can kind of inject into them a sense of urgency about the necessity for clean technology in the transportation sector.
Renegade was our first battery electric car, and we're hoping to apply all the stuff that we've learned to our future projects. We're going to start with an innovative street legal scooter and then scale this up to a full-scale car.